I want to start with a proposition that goes like this. History can only be dull if we make it that way. History class is a nightmare to many students, not because it's scary, they would like that, but because it's dull. The present is not dull. The present, while we have terrorist attacks and we've got threats of new diseases, we've got climate change, threats of natural disasters, famines, so we've got corrupt and philandering politicians, we have celebrity romances. The present is not boring. The past, by contrast, is made up of, well, wars, terrorist attacks, philandering politicians, corrupt politicians, famines, diseases. You see, tomorrow the same stories that rivet us today are part of the past. The past is not boring. It can only be dull if we make it that way, and we have made it that way. In our enthusiasm to cover the syllabus, I think, to show the big picture, to paint that vast canvas of history that they pay us the big bucks to do, we've squeezed out the fun and the fascination out of history. To go from Plato to NATO, you have to take the flesh off the bones. It's as if we entice our students into the classroom by offering them this voluptuous, fleshy muse, Cleo, and then deliver up her bare, dry bones. I know I do this in my classroom. And it always puzzles me when I have such fascinating material how I can bore people to death with it. And part of the explanation, because I don't think it's just me, I think part of the explanation goes like this. History becomes dull when we take the mystery out of it. And when we deprive the students of the real work of doing history, finding the clues, as you were saying, quoting from the website, solving the puzzles. The dates, the names, they're important, but they're not history. They're the context that we need to be able to do history. So, second proposition, history is too important to be boring. It's not to say that history should be entertaining. History is not entertainment, quite the opposite. History is serious business, deadly serious. Many of the current wars, current civil wars in our world today, I think, are the result of historical myths passed off as truths to a population or populations who don't have the tools to critically evaluate them. To critically evaluate those stories, to critically recall and evaluate the past, those are fundamental skills for a functioning society, and so it's imperative that we teach it well. History tells us who we are, where we have come from, and it reminds us, I think most important perhaps, it reminds us when we are lost, where we thought we wanted to go. History teaching is a serious undertaking, and if we make it dull, we have failed both the past and the future. Now, the advent of new technologies, computing, internet, as a mode of delivery, offers us many new ways to make history more boring.